कई साल पीएचडी करूँ ना सर,
एसोसिएट डीन पीजीआई, एसोसिएट डीन ऑफ हरगांव कॉलेज डॉक्टर एम सी आई रे सर, द मेजर कैप्टन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर कास्ट टीम डॉक्टर एस डी गोरंटीवार सर, को कन्वेनर्स एम जी शिंदे सर, देन ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी डॉक्टर एम बी धानवार सर, एंड जॉइंट ऑर्गेनाइजर्स डॉक्टर डी के देवकर, एम आर पाटिल, डॉक्टर एस एस सदाफर, एंड ऑल द अदर ट्रेनिंग कोऑर्डिनेटर्स फॉर गिविंग मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शेयर माई एक्सपीरियंस यू कैन से in USA that what I did at that particular place. So without wasting much more time, I would like to start the sharing. So first of all, I will just share one or few things with you people, and then we will have a more interactive section rather than to have, you can say, one or more like presentation or like that. So definitely we will be doing in this way. I am going to share a few things with you people to start, to get start with. So just now you can say the organizers have given me given my nice introduction. Thank you for that one. Actually they have given much more about me rather than what I am. So before you can say start, it was a very small step in my life, or you can say that journey or that small step was leading me to a, you can say, 1,000 miles that already has begun and that are about to go, or you can say miles and miles ago. So actually, whenever you can say when I was I still consider myself as a student, but you can say since my school days, I you can say believe on this particular proverb or terminologies, that is, if death comes to me before I prove myself, definitely I will kill the death. So with that particular vision, with that particular motto, I started my journey, which you can say somehow, you can say struggles, then after you can say having, you can say, some opportunities, whatever the opportunities that you can say come in front of me, I used to grab those one, and then I proceeded my journey. But I would like to tell you, my dear friends, that if you can say you are what you call luck or life or whatever it may be, definitely that life or that luck will, you can say, knock your doors once or twice in your life. And at that time, if you are, you can say, feeling drowsy, lazy, or sleepy, then definitely you are going to lose those opportunities. And from that particular point of, you can say, time, that particular, you can say, point, definitely your struggle starts. So you need to grab those opportunities. You need to identify those opportunities. So just now, this, you can say, organizers told that I did my postdoctorate, or you can say I was a postdoctorate fellow of Michigan State University, East Lansing, Michigan, USA. So at the back, you can say bottom, you might have, you can say, seen the logo of one theme. You might have, you can say, seen the movie also. If not, then also go for watching that movie, 300, old 300 movie. It was a nice periodic movie. And this particular logo of that particular Michigan State University was taken from that. This particular logo or that helmet is known as Spartan. Spartan means the winner after long struggling. So definitely, if you go over there, definitely you will realize the symbolization of this party. So how I did all these things, that I'm going to share with you one by one, and then we will have an interactive session. Whatever the queries, questions, whatever the ideas that you people are having, you share, and definitely I will try, and I will also learn from you people. I will try to answer those, and I will try to learn from you people too. So this is my experience sharing. So being a MPKV employee, being a MPKV product, I started my journey with a well versatile academic career, as a result of which I got an opportunity to do my PhDs. And definitely this is a bedrock of your career. If you want to think about your career in academics, then your PhD or your post-graduation levels are considered to be the bedrocks. Definitely you need to think on this particular line. If your bedrock is weak, then definitely whatever the product, whatever the material that is going to roach, definitely that will not be a good, or that will not be productive. And I feel lucky, I feel fortunate to have my guide, research guide, a very known, you can say, pomegranate breeder or fruit breeder, Dr. A.R. Karale sir. With his vision, he was also my master's guide and at the same time was my PhD mentor. So with his view, I started my research career and I made my mind to be make a career in academics, even though I was a topper, or you can say I was excelling in my academics. So whenever you can say, after doing my you can say pursuing my PhD degree, I started thinking of going next level. So this next level was, you can say, then I came to know with the this what you call network and all those things, I came to know that there is such type of thing that postdoctorate level is being there, where you can have a good type of research, we can, you can make a network, and with the help of this you can change your vision. And definitely in our extension education, it is always been said that seeing is believing, and definitely that comes true. You need to visit, you need to interact with more and more people, then and then only you will enrich yourself, you will enlighten within you yourself. So yes, in this respect the topic is related with the postdoctoral fellow. Since last 2 days you might have came across the various types of things. So as a career orientation or as a selection, you need to make the choice of the fellowships that you need to you can say apply for. This choice of fellowship is a very, very important thing. Very important thing. The country which you want to visit, not only the country within India, you can also go for good postdoctoral journey. Postdoctoral journey. Definitely, it will be helpful for you people. Once you decide the fellowship that you are going to apply for, definitely your goal is set. Actually, in 2013, in January 2013, I started thinking of applying for the Nehru Fulbright Fellowship, which is in between, you can say, the mutual symbolization in between, symbiotic relationship in between India and USA. Definitely, I went through all these particular criteria. I was selected, I was shortlisted among the last two candidates. But that took a very long, you can say, the process. I started it in, you can say, January 2013, and that went on May 2013 for all these processes. And after that, one day I received a phone call from this, you can say, Nehru Fulbright Forum, that if you are willing to apply this for this particular fellowship, we will suggest that, or we will recommend to recommend you to apply this next year, because one candidate is being selected. So on the same day, I felt something like that, ask your mentor that whether it is being possible, you can say, to apply for the next year or like that. Then I called my US mentor, Dr. Randall Baudry. I really feel fortunate to have the mentors like, you can say, A.R. Karale sir, Dr. P.C. Tripathi, who is, as of now, he is working as principal scientist at IIHR Bengaluru. Then ex-vice chancellor of Dr. B.S.K. K.V. Dapoli, Dr. K.E. Lamande sir, then Dr. A.R. Karale sir, Dr. A.L. Farande sir. So these people came forward just like anything, and I will not forget one name, Dr. B.R. Ulmit sir. So fortunately, all these people you can say came across my life just like a pathfinders, and they have shown me the path. So when I, you can say, got such type of phone call, I immediately called my US mentor. Then you can say already my interviews were, you can see he had taken my interview. He has gone through my project proposal. Then he was also having one project. Then what he said, what he suggested, forget about Nehru Fulbright Fellowship. It will take a time. You will never come to know, because already from January 2013, you are processing all those things. And already May 2013 is passed. So I will offer you the fellowship from Michigan State University. And at that point of instant, definitely, You can say I feel very lucky, very fortunate to have a mentor like this. Only within two or three interviews, at we can say one meeting we had in you can say Maharashtra itself, when he was in his visit, he was on his visit to Maharashtra for the fruit crops. Then immediately he said that I am going to offer you the fellowship, and you will not believe, he offered me 2 years fellowship per year, $43,000 and plus $3,000 additional, which was much more than you can say Nehru Fulbright postdoctoral fellowship. And I got selected as a J1 scholar research. It is in between, you can say, scientist exchange program in between India and USA. So this choice of fellowship is very, very important thing. So once you decide, once you think of this particular choice, fellowship, then you need to select the country. Number of fellowships are being offered. Japan is also offering, Australia is also offering, no doubt China is also offering. Number, Finland, Belgium, if you want to make a career in your agriculture, then Netherlands and Belgium, these are providing, England, these are providing definitely good fellowships too. Next one, keep an eye on advertisements. Every day, every year, every month, you will find that, you can say, a new advertisement is being there. So if it is related with your subject, then definitely you can prepare accordingly and you can go for putting the shoes in your legs. That means you need to be ready with all, by all means. In the next slide, I am going to discuss how you are going to prepare. Next one is that application processing, which is very, very important. This application processing is not only related with the with your personal statement, but it is also related with the statement of purpose, then letters of recommendations, n number of things. So out of this letter of recommendation, personal statement, and project proposal, these are very, very important thing. These project proposals, on the basis of your PhD work, they used to screen it and they used to shortlist it. I feel you can say proud to share with you that in my life, I was shortlisted for three different countries, USA, Australia, and Israel. These three countries, I was, you can say, okay, shortlisted, but I went through, you can say, through the choice of, you can say, USA. Then I got an opportunity to visit Israel too. And during that particular visit, I got an opportunity to share a roundtable conference with World Bank chairman. And I represented India in that particular roundtable conference. So for all these things, your application, a statement of purpose must be strong. It must be strong enough. And for this, you people will require a technical guidance. We know everything that we have the ideas. I think in the last week itself, Bill Gates has, you can say, published one thing in his interview that India has a lot of potential. Indian youths have a lot of potential. You need to dig it out. That means we need to dig it out. So whatever the ideas that we people are having, we need to explore those. We need to put it on a paper. We need to give a shape. And then you will have to represent yourself in a good manner. So that is all related with the application processing. Then statement of purpose. This statement of purpose is very, very important thing. Again and again, I'm telling, whatever this statement of purpose is, that why you are choosing that country, why that university, why with that mentor, you need to get elaboration in your own words. And what are your, you can say, the strong points, and how you are going to strengthen your weaker things in this statement of purpose, you need to focus. So this particular thing is very important. Already you are having PhD degree. That means for few countries only, you need to give or appear for the exams like TOEFL and all those things, GRE, TOEFL. But as you are a PhD degree holder, definitely this statement of purpose will suffice your minimum eligibility requirement. Next one, the project proposal. My dear friends, I would strongly recommend or I will strongly tell you all people, especially for the MPKB people or the people who are from the Maharashtra universities. All these people, definitely, even though I am a faculty or academician, I am not able to give, I am not able to provide you the jobs. We can just provide you the path. And that is the main problem with us. As a result of which, we search for other competitive exams. And in order to get success, in order to crack those competitive exams, we definitely, we give a least attendance, least, you can say, vision to our postgraduate degree. As a result of which, our research levels are very, very low. It is very unfortunate. I am a very straight person. I need to make the remarks of these two. And once, after two attempts, three attempts or four attempts, then you start, you can say, beating the legs, beating around the bush. You need to find out these other jobs, that is to join academics and all those things. And at that point, you come to realization that your research proposals or your research work at your master's level or PhD level is not of that much, you can say, level that you can make a bright career. So start early, think positively, think wisely, and give at least 2 or 3 hours or whatever being required by the research for your project proposal. This particular PhD work, master's work, serves as a bedrock, main firm material for your career in academics. If that is strong, definitely you will, your vision will change, your ideas will strengthen, your academics will strengthen, and as a result of which, you can write a very good research proposal, which will be accepted very easily by the, you can say, the scientists. They are actually, what these people are doing, these mentors used to you can say, focus on you people. They used to extract the ideas from you people, and they used to shape up you. That is the thing they used to do. They provide a free platform. And once you go on that particular free platform, definitely your expression views, your vision, all will get broader. So for this reason, your project proposal must be stronger, which is based on your, you can say, PhD work. Then next one, that is actual interview, exam if needed. Definitely no exams are being conducted by the mentors, but they used to carry the actual interview if possible. Now due to Corona, virtual meetings are being, you can say, normal things. So they used to come, you can say, virtually. They extract you people, they extract your knowledge, they extract your basic knowledge. And I feel to share particular this thing. Definitely, I studied very hard at my bachelor's as well as my master's, which helped me a lot. But still then, when I went to USA, when on the very first day, I came to realization that we people are very weak in our basics, that we must agree. Specifically, if you are not from the social science, we are very weak in biochemistry. And if you want to make a good career, then definitely your biochemistry must be perfect one. If you are perfect in that one, definitely sky is the limit. Sky is the limit. You can say, you can note down my words, you can mark my words, definitely sky is the limit. And through that actual interview, they will extract the things that you have done during your master's as well as your doctoral degree. So this is very important. Then after that, definitely these people are very frank. These people are very straightforward. If they like you, they will not, you can say that after 15 days, we will think or like that. Immediately they will say, I am having this project, you have submitted this project, we will have a collaboration or we will take your project. You can say otherwise, this leave about that project, we will work on my project. And definitely without wasting much more time, or within 1 hour, or you can say less than 24 hours, they will reply you and they will positively say you that you can go for visa application that will be processed by the university department. They will give you each and everything. that invitation letter and all those things, they will J1 scholar, research scholar applications, everything they will provide. And at the same time, they will give a call at the embassy that this student is being needed, this particular faculty, this particular scientist is being needed by the university for this and this project. This will help Indian population as well as American population. So this will make your journey very safe, very, very safe. Then visa interview and franking. They will, you can say, just check you that whether you are going to have a permanent residence in USA or you are just going to have a research and you are going to come back. And immediately in front of you, they will allot that, yes, best luck and all those things. And your passport will go for franking and all those things. And then you can come out of USA embassy with flying and you can prepare for your flight to USA. So have a safe flight. But for this safe flight, what you need to do? How to win, PDF, postdoctoral fellowships. Definitely, just now I told you that you need to have a strong PhD work and a plan. If you are having a strong PhD work, then definitely you will have days for your research. You will have your base for research, and then you can think that whatever in last paragraph we used to write usually in our dissertation, that future plans and future perspectives. Accordingly, you can prepare your plan that no, these things after research, you come to know, no, these things are being left from my study. I want to do this particular thing. Accordingly, you can make a plan. And as far as my particular plan was considered, definitely I thought, actually I wanted to be a breeder, good breeder, as well as a post-harvest technologist. And I can proudly say that as of now, I am a good, I am working as a, post-harvest physiologist and technologist in my university. I am still working on particular aspects. On my PhD work was on, pomegranate processing. It was a huge voluminous work. I used to go for, modified atmosphere packaging of ready to eat, or fresh pomegranate areas. Then I used to prepare, antioxidant extraction from the concentrates as well as cold juice, cold treated juice, pomegranate juice. Likewise, I prepared a number of products and we have finalized that particular SOP, standard operating procedure for pomegranate processing. And by that means, we can proudly say that our university, MPKV, is having the each and every, that is from the soil selection to its, consumer plating regarding this particular pomegranate. That is complete production and processing technology regarding pomegranate we are having. And due to this particular work on ready to eat, modified atmosphere packaging and antioxidant, these three were my peculiar points, peculiar things which were highlighted keywords of my research work. And accordingly, I plan to go for, ready to eat foods with the modified atmosphere packaging. Then letters of recommendations. This is very important thing. Then when I came forward, definitely every coin has two sides. When I came with this thing, I'm still a faculty. And at that time also I was working as assistant professor of horticulture in Kolhapur, the same college from where I'm delivering the lecture or discussing with you people as of now. So at that time, when I came forward with some, project, many people think that I am a stupid person, I am an idiot person, but it is very well said that history is always made by the idiot peoples. And I was such an idiot. Definitely I came forward with a thing that every fruit or a vegetable, if you take into consideration, I was still considering the pomegranate as the future thing for research. when you keep that particular fruit, after detaching that particular fruit or harvesting from the plant, definitely it starts their own physiology. It still continues its respiration and transpiration. It releases water. At the same time, it will require oxygen. It releases ethylene. So what I thought, if we want to remove such type of, if you want to increase the shelf life of the pomegranate aerials, then we need to remove these certain types of the off flavors, which is released by the pomegranate aerials after, you can say, opening of the fruit. What will happen if you can say we will provide a packaging? And accordingly, I made a project and I submitted that project to that particular university, this Randolph Bodry, who is the first three among the three best post harvest physiologists in the world, among the first three. He liked my project, you can say, he liked my way. Then he suggested me that, he called me, Sangram, don't go for focusing only on a single fruit. That pomegranate, we don't have in Michigan, we don't have pomegranate. Ours, you can say, the area is always being on under, you can say, the snow for more than 8 months. We get only 4 months. Rather to go for choosing for one, working on one crop, we will have a technology. We will develop a technology that will be applicable to entire horticulture crops, or you can say the majority of the horticultural crops. And with that, we come forward with, you can say, one plan, that is metal organic framework technology. He was already having that project. He gave me that idea. I was also not, you can say, knowing about that metal organic framework technology till that time. And you will also surprise that future of a fuel industry lies with this particular thing, that is metal organic framework technology. It is having the adsorbent property that 1 milligram is capable to adsorb 10 milligrams or even 10 grams of fuel or anything. And what we thought, if we use such type of the molecules in the packaging of the vegetables or the fruits, which are fresh cut, after fresh cut, they release volatiles. If those volatiles get adsorbed on these one, and when the consumer opens the packet, at that time, if that particular metal organic framework releases those volatiles in the packet, as a result of which the plant or these tissues, plant tissues, will get absorption of those volatiles, as a result of which the consumer will feel freshness while consumption. So I put forward this particular concept, which was being discussed with, you can say, the international scientists. Literally many of the person with whom I came in contact with them, they said that this is rubbish thing. This will not happen. Why you are thinking like this? And as a result of which, I couldn't get letters of recommendation. But definitely, just like a lighthouse in a sea, you will always get some, you can say, pathfinders, some lighthouses in your life. As a result of which, you can say, I got Dr. K. Lavandesar, Dr. P.C. Tripathi, my research guide, A.R. Karale, definitely he was always with me. He came with those letters of recommendation. They understood my concept. Dr. A.R. Farandesar, he's a soil scientist. He understood the things that I am going to do, what I wanted to do. And all these people, they gave me a letters of recommendation. See, my dear friends, at one time, I was not able to collect or convince a single person to have a single letter of recommendation. And at one time, I was having more than 4 letters of recommendations, which were from, you can say, the higher authorities too. So this is very, very important. The letters of recommendation of reputed personalities will work in winning the postdoctoral fellowships. Those, you can say, letters of recommendations should be based on your research recommendations. Not on your, you can say, I know him personally, he is my relative, or like that. It will not work at all. It only works in our places, not outside. Then mentors. Just now I gave, you can say, the list of the names. See, without a mentor, even if whatever you are learning on online or all those things, it is okay to avoid academic loss. But without mentor, without guru, you won't get any success. You won't be a human being. You will be a only, you can say, a living being, but not a human being. And for this reason, you need mentors. And definitely, I feel proud to have n numbers of mentors. I can name n numbers of mentors. They have shaped up my life. They have shaped up my academic career. List already I gave the few names. And apart from that, Randy Baudry was the person. When I searched on, you can say, internet, you people are very much lucky. During my, you can say, PG work, I was not that bit lucky. That at that time, you can say, internet and all those things were, we were laggards in those things. We were not doing those things. Even my father was, you can say, the horticulturist. But I was not knowing that there is such type of, you can say, the fellowship known as JRF. Being, even though I was a university topper, I could not apply for the JRF. So in this case, definitely mentors have the place. If such people come across your life, they will tell what to do. But I believe on the people, those who are telling you what not to do. These people told me that what not to do, what is to eliminate from me. And if you know your weaknesses, you can strongly work on those weaknesses. And of course, everyone has weaknesses and strengths. And the strengths are needed to be more, you can say, more to be strengthened. And for this particular point, mentors are being needed. And I found Dr. Randall Baudry as a good mentor for me, because he was the one of the physiologists, one of among three in the world. Eli Felik from the Israel, he was the second. I came also across, you can say, with him. I shared 21 days with that Eli Felik. And one is from Belgium. That these three people are considered to be the best, you can say, the technologies. But I chose, you can say, Randall Baudry, as he is from USA. So this choice of mentors is also lies with you people. You need to write email, you need to contact with them, you need to converse with them, you need to have a communication with them. And once they feel that, no, this student is having the spark, he is going to prove his mettle, then definitely they will call you themselves. And after presenting my PhD work, Randall Baudry was the person who initiated the conversation. So for these people to think, mentor selection is very important, that is in your hands. Then background knowledge of what? Definitely, my new dear friend, let's start from ourselves. You must know your background knowledge. We are very weak in English. We think in our, you can say, mother language, or you can say vernacular languages. That creates an impact more negatively in expressing ourselves. You need to remove that thing. You need to cull that particular, you can say, level, lack of confidence that you cannot express yourself in your own language. Definitely Japanese people are expressing in Japanese. Then Chinese people, no need to tell you. Why not we people are writing our researches in Hindi, in our Tamil language, in our Marathi? We should come forward this. So we need to know our background knowledge, background base. Then you need to know the background knowledge level of your mentor. You need to know the knowledge of your university where you are going to apply. If I am a man from dry land, if I am thinking to work on pomegranate, and if I am going, or if I am catching the bus which is going to Michigan, where nearly about 8 months the soil is covered with snow, will it work? Definitely it will not work. Then you need to switch on. You need to switch your way. Just like my mentor told me, forget about pomegranate. We will develop a product which will work for all. Likewise, you need to have a background knowledge. then if you are having all these things, if you are having the good communication, then you can come forward with a good precise research plan with a specific targeted research goals that you are going to achieve within a stipulated period of a time. Postdoctorate is not a thing that you need to go over there for 2 years or 3 years. It is not a degree. It is an outcome of the research plan, research work that you people are planning. It may be of 2 months, it may be of 3 months, it may be of 1 year, 2 years, 5 years. Many people of my age are still doing their postdoctoral fellowships or postdoctoral work, because they, simultaneously they are getting the salaries as a result of these postdoctorates. So you need to come forward with the research plan, sound research plan with a sound action plan as well as your goals. Then motivation and training goals. This is very much needed. I already shared one thing, one story regarding my, you can say, Fulbright, Nehru Fulbright Fellowship. At one day before, I got a letter that I have been shortlisted. We were the only two persons, and definitely I was going to win that particular postdoctoral fellowship. And very next day, I get a call from, you can say, that particular organization that I can apply. They will consider me eligible for the next year. So at that time, you will be in a dilemma. You will get frustrated. But already very first slide I started with, if death comes to me before I prove myself, definitely I will kill the death. I came forward just what I am. When I stand in front of mirror, definitely I express myself. In that way, I express all the things to my mentor in US. And he then come forward with a $43,000 fellowships plus 3,000 contingency grants. Forget about all these things. They have sponsored our 2 international conferences. So for this, you need to motivate yourself. And at the same time, why you are going for postdoctoral things, you need to specify your training goals. That is what I told you. You need to rectify your weaknesses. If you know the weaknesses, then you will tell, no, these things I did for my PhD work. I want to do these things. And these things are available with you people. Definitely, whatever the things I have that I can share with you, you can share the things that you people are having. It is a two-way process, give and take relationship that you need to strengthen. And accordingly, you can fix your training and motivational goals. Then after achieving all these things, then you can come forward with yourself. You can represent yourself now. That is with the personal statement and resume. Definitely, personal statement is the expression of what you are. It doesn't matter that of what caste you are. It doesn't matter that what skin color you are having. Definitely it doesn't matter. What matters all that how you are going to represent yourself in front of those people. My dear friends, in the world, only 2 people or 2 citizens of 2 countries are considered to be the brilliant people and hardworking people, smart working people, Chinese people and Indian people. So you need to represent yourself in that particular way. It is not like that in India on roads, we are going to spitting. We can just launder here and there like that. When you go in US, you become a gentleman or gentlewoman. It is not like that. Whatever you are, that they will extract. And as a result of that, you need to come forward with what you are. That is related with the personal statement and resume. Then what you think, whatever the things that you have prepared before the submission of application, you need to go for proofreading. Just now in my this slide and previous slide, one spelling mistake was there. Even I, whatever PhD I have written, the way is wrong. In previous slide, doctoral spelling of the doctoral was wrong. So likewise, you need to nullify your mistakes made by you. That will make your statement, that will make your application very, very stronger, and there will not be any, you can say, the hindrance to win a fellowship. So once you win the fellowship, definitely you are not only representing yourself, but you are representing your country, you are representing your university, you are representing your family, you are representing your state, you are representing your culture. So for be a good, you can say, successful postdoc candidate, what things you need to have? You need to study the project very hard. Your ideas of your project, that must be cleared one. Then take the ownership of your project. Many things happens, just like it is an Indian mentality, of course. When you go outside with your own ideas, if there is another Indian, he will come, he will talk with you, they will help, but at some point, they will snatch your ideas. Don't let that happen it again. You come forward, be a team, be a part, and you can come forward to have ownership. Ownership, that doesn't mean that you are having whole and sole authority of that project. It is not like that. Whatever the ideas, whatever the work that you are going to do, that some people will come to ask you that, tell me how to do these and these things. Be a master trainer of your project. Then read broadly. When it will come, that master training, read broadly and learn more about the research. Whatever research you are going to carry, your all ideas, entire ideas, basics must be cleared to you. I will let you know that these people, specifically Western people, USA people, they will help you. They will show you everything for once, twice. And after that, they will leave you as it is. They will leave you as it is. You need to struggle it hard. If you go on our Indian roads, you will get number of people to tell you the road. But on, you can say, your USA highways, the GPS is your partner. Likewise, in the lab too, for 1 or 2 days, 1 or 2 weeks, they will conduct a training and they will leave the project to you. You can do whatever you want. You can break the glasses, you can break the instrument, whatever you want, but they want the results. That's all. In Marathi, we call it as a bab dakav naitar shraddaga. So that is the thing. Next, try to learn new things. By this way only, you can learn the new things. Even if you are not on your project work, you can just go on the projects which are running in your library, in your lab, under your mentorship, your mentor's mentorship. You can learn those things too. And it is good thing that once they know that this particular person is hardworking, then they will, even if your project is completed, they will take you to another project. Then training adaptability. This is what adaptability. You need to keep yourself always open for the trainings, number of trainings that you people are, those people are eager to give you. That is known as training adaptability. Then position yourself to get good letters of reference. Not only on your lab, you can make a good rapport so that in a future also, you can get a good letters of references. With these USA letters of references, I could go to Indonesia, then I can go to Israel twice. So these are certain things that I couldn't manage to get. Even for the Australian fellowship, I could get through that particular fellowship, but I could not go due to some my personal reasons. Then learn to write scientific papers and to give scientific talks. This is very important. You need to express yourself. We people do a good research work. Definitely that in our breeding, some many things we are going doing very good things, but we are not expressing those things in a good papers, or you can say good rated papers. That I can say, I can proudly say that I can name one of, you can say, my colleague's name, Dr. Sachin Dingre. He wrote last month itself, I think, he wrote 4 good papers having a NAS rating more than 9.41 along with Dr. Gorantivar sir. So this particular thing we need to inculcate in ourselves. Even one of my student has wrote one article which is having NAS rating, you cannot even imagine, 17.1. I am one of the author in that. It is already being, you can say, published. I think today only it will release online in trends in, you can say, food processing. 17.1 rating is there. This particular research database will make your career in the future. So as a result, to have a best post, successful postdoc, you need to learn about the scientific papers. For this, your statistics, software, you can say, friendly, techno savvy things will help you in all the way. Then be a family of lab and department. Whatever you are preparing at your home, bring it to your lab, circulate, you can say, share with among your, you can say, lab mates. It will make a bond. Share small, small things. So be a family, as a result of which they will also miss you. Then learn organizational things. Definitely, we are having number of protocols. But when you go abroad, your vision will change. Even many, you can say, vice chancellor is called as a president of the university. The president will also come in his shorts, or you can say t-shirt or like that. He will pat on your, you can say, body, and he will say, hi Sangram, how are you? And the students used to call, hi Jack, like that. So those particular organizational skills, the culture that you need to adapt. We used to call every person, even 1 year senior is there, we used to call sir, sir, sir. That is okay in our Indian culture, but that will not work in, you can say, USA culture, because they will say that you are, they will believe, they will trust that this particular person is still not a part of their family. So you need to learn the organizational thing and definitely network. As a result of, you can say, whenever you are going abroad, you are developing your own network. You are becoming a part of the networks, others' network. So that is very, very important. These particular things, we can say, are very important. Then definitely whenever you are talking with any pedestrian, any, you can say, the person who is walking by the road, be clear with your views and expressions. What you want to do, tell them very clearly. If certain things you don't, you can say, like those particular things, express them. They will adapt those things. They will appreciate those things. And if those things are right, they will accept those things. That is the biggest thing. Your biggest, you can say, positive attitude those people are having. And last but not the least, whatever the things that you people are have, you need to express yourselves by having, by adopting various communication skills. You need to have, you need to develop good communication skills. If you are weak in English, no doubt, no, forget about that. You express those by the virtue of actions, by the virtue of work you are doing in the lab. As a result of which, you will be a very, you can say, you will be a very successful postdoc. As a, you can say, alumni of Michigan State University, I can tell you all that be a Spartan. You can clearly see the three persons in the photograph. One is my mentor, Dr. Randall Baudry. He is working himself. He is not, you can say, telling us that take the readings. He is showing us his another project. The lady, or you can say, not lady exactly, she is a girl, just 11-year-old girl of 6th standard. In USA, there is, you can say, one move that the students of 6th to 10th standard, they should come up with 15 days to 1 month project, and the laboratories in the universities may allow them to work in that particular place. And she came with that one. She was working on ginkgo. Ginkgo is a fruit in USA. And we were working on the biochemistry of that ginkgo. And we were observing on, you can say, IGS mass, mass spectrometer. On that we are, you can say, observing some of the readings. So this is all. If you want, I can stop sharing. I will share you this some of the facilities. I will share you some of the facilities. I want to show you some of the photographs. Those photographs I can show you. So these are some of the photographs that I want to share. So he is another, you can say, lab mate, Patrick Abelli. He is an undergrad student who was working. We were working in a globe box. This is related with my project, that is use of metal organic frameworks for enhancing the shelf life of fresh cut foods, crops. He is doing the work in a globe box. He is another Indian, Mr. Pangal. He is actually a physicist, you can say the scholar of physics, who was a Raman fellow over there. He was also working with me. That is what I call it, that you can have a network, good network. He is using my instrument. He was working in my lab. See, I am in action. So these are certain things. So this is lab. I want to share a few things. You can say in June I got this fellowship, and with the all government permissions, it took almost 6 months to join US, my lab in USA. That particular tag, this one in USA. This is another, you can say, the person over there, Mr. Prabhat. He is a faculty in Beats Pilani. He is also nanonuclear, this nuclear scientist who was working with the nuclear lab in Michigan State University. We were the roommates and all those things. So what I wanted to share, that when you can say all these particular permissions from state government, I would like to specially mention those things. Because I submitted my file once again after getting that particular letters of invitation from USA in the month of June. I submitted immediately in the month of, you can say, first fortnight of July. Then the journey of that particular file started. My university took, you can say, almost 2 months to send it to government of Maharashtra. And government of Maharashtra, as far as my government of Maharashtra is concerned, if you want to have the permission, the file has to go through 73 tables. In September, it has gone to Maharashtra, I think 30th of September was that date. On you can say, I went to Mantralaya on 1st of October. 2nd October was the holiday. Then from 3rd October, you can say, I directly met Principal Secretary of Agriculture, Mr. Sudhir Goyal sahab. Then he called me when my biodata and all these letter of invitations, he gone through that one. Went through that one. Then he called me. Then very first question he asked me, why you are so late? You have almost lost 6 months. Then I was speechless. Then immediately he called his deputy secretary, his under secretary, and he told me that tomorrow I am leaving for assembly to Nagpur. By the evening, this file should get clear. Forget about all those 73 tables. Only 3 signs were there. And I feel very proud that on 15th of October, I got full-fledged approval from the government of Maharashtra to join. Then that file came to university. It took almost more than 2 months to relieve me for catching that particular program. And on 31st of December, I caught my flight. You will also surprise that, you can say, whenever these particular things are coming, then it won't come in a single way. Those coming are by from all the sides. जब ये संकट आता है तो एक जगह से नहीं आता है, सारी जगह से आता है. दे विल टेस्ट यू. एंड वेन आई सीट इन द फ्लैट वेन सॉरी फ्लाइट वेन आई कैच दैट फ्लाइट इमीजिएटली विद इन 8 hours वी केम टू नो दैट यूएस हैज बीन हिट बाय यू कैन से हेल स्टॉर्म्स इन यू कैन से इट वॉज नेवर इन द हिस्ट्री एंड माई फ्लाइट वॉज स्टक इन द पैरिस. I used to spend, you can say, almost one day over there. And when I landed in Lansing, Detroit, actually Detroit, from Detroit, I took a second flight to Lansing. When I came outside of that particular, you can say, airport, the outside temperature was minus 54 degrees Celsius. Even if a single centimeter of my skin is exposed to that particular environment, it will get a frozen and it will get a bleed out. My mentor's wife came to catch me. Then she took me in her, you can say, SUV there. For the first time, I sat in a perfect SUV for the first time, which is having a massage seat. Then what do you call? You can say the ventilated seats, hot ventilated seats. Then they took me to a hotel, which is just was nearby. You can say the university, not nearby in the university itself. They were running. You can say university's hotel. You will surprise that whatever the Kellogg's and all those things flakes you are eating, the Kellogg's is the alumni of that Michigan State University. Varghese Kurian is the alumni of that university. Michael Jordan is the university best basketball player, is the you can say alumni of that university. And I too, I am also the alumni of that particular university. I feel proud to share all these things. When very next day in the early in the morning, they are very particular about time. They came, that particular lady asked me, that by what time you will be ready, you will have jet lag and all those things. Then I said that by 7 o'clock, definitely I'll be ready. Then by 7 in the morning, she knocked my door. I can say definitely I was ready. And then I actually, she took me to the university administration office. I was having this sweater, jacket and all those things, monkey cap on my head. She asked me, that particular lady asked me to sit on a chair, and I just produced, you can say, the letter of invitation to them. Immediately they on the same chair, they took one photograph and they handed me one identity card. That identity card was a magnetic chip, which was a password for all the facilities in the across the university, including their bus service. If I used to swipe that card, I can travel free of cost from my, you can say, Spartan village to my lab or within the university, wherever you can say, or to the market too. See how fast is the process. Then paperless work. I came to know the importance of the paperless work. I submitted, they just asked me, you can say, one, you can say, online form I used to submit. I used to submit this particular, what do you call, flight charges and all those things, flight ticket and boarding pass. They never asked me the boarding pass. They know that this person came from India and at present he is in East Lansing. That means he might have came by the, by using the flight, not by, you can say, walking or not doing any mischievous thing. Within 2 days, entire fellowship amount of that month, for that month, along with my fare charges, were credited to my account, which was created on very first day. That is the difference. Clearly, my vision is totally changed. Definitely, I am a student of, you can say, Services Preparatory Institute, having the army background. So I am having some sort of, so you can say, the timeliness, some sort of tidiness, but still then, this particular thing has enriched me. and as a result of which you can say that project was for one you can say year, which was about to extend to 2 years, but we worked very hard, and as a result of which by the end of 10th you can say month, that project came with the positive you can say outcomes, as a result of which we can say I need to come back as a faculty definitely. Once that particular project was being over, actually they offered me another project, but I had to come back. So this is in all about my experience. Definitely I wanted to share you can say the lab facilities which were having over there facilities. I want to show you those particular lab facilities too. Just a minute. Many techniques I could you can say learn over there. Okay, if you are able to watch, you can see those particular thing. Do you you can say see this picture? So this is my total lab. You will surprise, this lab is totally underground. They were having you can say I wanted to share one experience. Really, Michigan State University is considered to be the best university for the agriculture research in USA, and this particular university has started agriculture basics of the agriculture research in USA. That's why in the month of I think June 2014, they wanted you can say USA government, federal government wanted to launch a new agricultural policy, and for that reason the then president Mr. Barack Obama he was about to come to Michigan State University, and that particular venue was just you can say 50 meters away from my lab. President of USA was coming just 50 kilometers away from my lab, but my you can say mentor was working that with us. Then surprisingly I asked my you can say mentor that hi doctor, your president is in your university, you are the university you can say the PG program coordinator, and still then you are here. Why it is so? Why you are not gone for the particular that particular venue? What is said was clearly indicating the devotion to their work. He said president came here to declare the agriculture policy. He is doing his duty and I am supposed to do my duty. See the difference. Are hamare yahan to hamare yahan ka parshad bhi aata hai, to we used to gather. Sorry, I am very straightforward, but the president of USA was coming over there, but each and every person in the university except the president of university were working in their labs. Even we were not being stopped at any place ki yahan se mat jao waise mat jao, jaise abhi Donald Trump ke bare mein hua hai Washington DC mein, waisa us time nahi hua tha. That was never took place. So you can see these particular lab photos. This is the corridor of my lab. This is the place where I used to sit and work. See each and every all these facilities. You will get shower, emergency shower is there, emergency you can say facilities are being there. This is my post service lab A27, the place, the room where I used to sit. So these were you can say the displays for their research works. See biocarbonate and ascorbic activate, one amino cyclopropane, one carboxylate oxidase. What does it mean? Ye sab dikha raha hai lab mein. Ye dekho, this is a good you can say freelancing what you call blackboard, where you can do anything, you can discuss anything. This is the place where I wrote something, that is MOF, metal organic framework, how these people this is going to work. So this is another one. This is what done by myself itself. Shape and all those things. This is, you can say, the corridor and display boards of that particular lab. This is the place. This is pantry on the left hand side. This is the place where you can say this one. Patrick was sitting, and these were the Wi-Fi enabled printers, as well as you can say you can do n number of printings. You can have, you can say, n number of you can say softwares that you can use. You can learn about those things. If you feel tired, you can come. You can have your own coffee, tea. You can make a breakfast. Whatever you want, you can do anything. So this is, you can say, display boards of you can say Apple. Apple, it is very famous lab for Apple work. So this is, you can say, pantry with microwave, coffee maker, some sort of, you can say, things which were purchased by the library of university itself. So this is my place of work. This is my lovely place of work, where I used to sit hours and hours with this, you can say, gas chromatograph and all those things. Entire lab key was with us. There is no need to take a permission and all those things. When you enter by punching your card, it is automatically been registered with their software system. Whenever there is a fire alarm is there, immediately it will flash on your, you can say, monitor in your lab that Dr. Sangram, you are in your lab, please vacate the place. Like this. This is the, you can say, the post-harvest lab. There are members everywhere. You will see how many foreigners they have visited in this particular corner. So these are the cylinders, or you can say various oxygen cylinders in my lab, my another place of work. This is another one. This is very, you can say, sophisticated instrument. Spectrometry is being there done on this one. IGS-MAS. You can see this one. Hewlett-Packard. It is Hewlett-Packard GC system on which we have worked. And the person, Randy, he was himself an engineer. He has developed his own probe for, you can say, identification of different types of volatiles. This is another. You can see the toolkits, just like a garage. Each and every instrument is being repaired by scientists themselves. They don't call repair persons. See the cylinders, how these are being tied. This is another one. This is Ginkgo procedure tools. This is CO2 analyzer and O2 analyzer. This is, you can say, helium and hydrogen things are being on, gas spectrometer, GC, very old instruments. These are, you can say, control atmospheric storage structures, which are structured in a lab itself for our studies. This is control panel of control atmospheric storage structures. See all these things. And I feel proud that one of such type of structure, we have submitted one project in Kolhapur itself, and it is being approved. And I am waiting for the, you can say, the fundings from those particular people. So these are another chambers of control atmospheric storage, where the apples, where peach, pear, plums are being stored, and research work is being done. DNAs are being frozen over here. So this is, you can say, the germinator lab. You can see the post-harvest. Now this is, you can say, biotechnology lab, where each and everything is being very clean. See how this planting material and pots and filling trays are being shared, are being kept. See the cleanliness. See everything they have written. Attention, please keep us clean. Keep this area clean and reduce the spread of plant diseases by cleaning up yourself. Aap khud ko bhi clean rakho aur area bhi clean rakho. There is no need to tell. Hamare yahan to signal bhi red ho jayega, tab bhi bhag jayenge. See the cleanliness. See the sure mix, the media, radio earth, sure mix. These are the you can say containers which contains these medias, Arabidopsis mix, specifically for you can say biotechnology. These are being needed. See the deodorized water, non-potable water, plant water, which you can use, you can take for the purposes you can have. See, this is another refrigerator where you can say molecular plant size things, you can say whatever your primers and all those things are being kept. See the thermoscientific here, what your PCRs, this is a big PCR. See the plants, see the you can say the project work. This is the premises of the main building, South Wanderers. See the paths, see the cleanliness, see the dirt. You were also the student of you can say your own universities. Many from apart from MPKV, many other students might have joined. But here, whatever things happen, we broke the glasses and all those things. But see the premises, see the ground. Each and every place is Wi-Fi enabled. See the tennis court. See the tennis court, Michigan State tennis court. See, this is the stadium. Stadium. This is stadium. So this is undergrad student who is helping the postdoctorate people as well as scientists. He is sowing seeds of Arabidopsis. See, he is sowing the seeds of, you can say, cucumber. This is cucumber work. So I think with this I can stop over here. If you are having any doubts, if you want to ask me anything, I will try to answer those questions, or I will try to satisfy you. But at the same time, I am also considering myself as a learner. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, topic is open. Ask one by one. Yes, is do you have any question? Do you have any thing that you want to ask me? Hello.
Yes, sir. Now participants are invited questions.
Okay, my email ID and okay, this one number that you can share, I think. Okay, I can share my number in my in chat box. Okay. Yes. So, कौन नसेल तर बघा मग. Sir, I am presently studying my bachelor's. I want to know whether it is better to go abroad for master's program. Definitely, it is very better to go for the master's program. For that, you need to give certain, you can say, the exams like GRE, TOEFL, or all those things. And definitely, you will get success in that one because now the world is very shortened. Okay, Ashish is saying feeling energetic. You are the energy of the country, definitely. Yes. Anything else? Okay, very glad to hear you, sir. How to dream big, sir? Okay. Sky is the limit, my dear friend. Broaden your mind broaden your brain too. If your brain is having the, you can say, sky like concepts, then sky is yours. While your surroundings are far away from this, while helping, need a helping hand. Always, that's why this caste team is helping you people. Then you can say the many speakers are with you, the persons like me. You just need to search around you people. You will find number of hands, those who are, you can say, offering their hands. Oh, sir, they unmute karu shakat nahi yet tyanna, asa te mantay. You can raise your hand so that caste people will unmute you. One Durgeshwari Ratnakar, she has raised her hand. Okay, Aprajita Kshatriya, she asked that best place to go for MSc Horticulture. So on which topic, or you can say on which subject you want to go for, depending on that, definitely you can choose the places. But I think Israel is the best place to go for, where you can go very easily. Then next, I will give this chance to Australia and then USA.
Mohini Dangi, madam, please ask your question.
Hello, sir.
Hello. Thank you. Go ahead.
Hello, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yes,
ma'am. Very clear. Very clear.
Sir, there is a small query from my end. You told ki there are n number of difficulties for in-service candidates. So just want to know ki just now I have completed my in-service PhD. Okay. So if I want to go for postdoctoral, what is the duration which I need to complete, or what will be the procedure?
See, okay, thank you. Same like me. Just you need to check out with your, you can say, the leaves that you people are having. If the leaves are in your credit, see, entire 1 year I was on, you can say, without pay holidays, without pay leave was there. So entire 1 year, more than 10 months, I was without pay. The only thing is that if your project is good one, then definitely government, your university will also not create a bar for you people. So you should come forward with that one, and you can have 3 months or 6 months postdoctoral program. And minimum, at least you can say 6 months doctoral program will suffice your all the criteria. Through that 6 months work, you need to come up with minimum at least one paper.
Okay, sir.
Okay. One question.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot for sharing.
Thank you. Thank you. There is one question from Rahul Chahande. If we are looking for postdoc immediately after our PhD, but due to certain formalities like fellowship, and like that, if we lock behind for certain time, does it matter to get the admission? No, not at all. It is up to you people, and it is in between your mentor and all those things. It is not a degree program that you should start within that particular span of time. It is not like that. But if your mentor is forcing you that you should come within this particular time, then you need to follow those particular guidelines, instructions.
Yogit Chaudhary, hello.
Hello. Hello, sir.
Yes.
So, Yogit from this side, I just had this query that, as you said earlier, that students from standard 6 are able to work in labs in US. So is it possible that for BSc Agri students of MPKV University, that any suggestions that where they can work in any certain labs?
Okay. Hi, Yogit. It is a very good question. But this question can be answered very, you can say, in a pretty manner by caste people. Already our university is having, you can say, certain type of a project under the caste. Our university has already taken lots of students to, I think, Thailand, Singapore, and as well as US too. So you people can come forward, but due to corona, certain restrictions are being there as of now. But certainly, okay, there is, you can say, the student exchange program also.
Okay, so...
Yes, GS Pawar.
GS Pawar, hello.
Sir, may I audible, sir?
Huh.
Yeah.
It is very wonderful lecture, sir. Actually, I am doing my postdoc at IRI recently. So I have joined here.
Nice. But, congratulations.
But let me congratulate first the CAST MPKV team, because they are providing such a wonderful platform to the newcomers who are willing to go abroad or who are willing to do their postdoc, because earlier there was no such provision. Like Sangram sir was also telling that there are lots of difficulties to go through this all this process. So it is a really wonderful experience, and really Sangram sir, you had a lot of experience from Michigan University, and you had showed each and every photographs. So it is like a virtual visit to the Michigan University, and I must congratulate you for these your achievements.
Thank you. Okay, Sulayya Rashid, she has asked, she or he has asked, best place public university for PhD in agronomy. Presently, I am about to complete my MSc agronomy this year from Scott Kashmir. Kindly guide me. You want to do it abroad or where? You can say in our, you can say India. In India, many places you might be knowing, definitely. But if you want to go for abroad, in, as far as the agronomy is concerned, Michigan State University is also good. Then your Arizona University is also good. But depends on this question can be answered very particularly based on your master's research. What type of the research you are conducting, depending on that, I can suggest you the university. Yes, next please. Yes, I think we can quit now. We can stop. MSc research is based on crop soybean. It is not like that. On soybean, what you are doing, that is that matters most. Definitely soybean. If you want to soybean, then you can say one of the university, Alabama University, is doing good work on this soybean as well as groundnut. Integrated nutrient management. Then you must go for applying in Michigan State University. They are having a really good lab as well as work on integrated nutrient management of the crops. Next one. Okay, if no doubts, then I think let me thank each and every member of the CAST team. Conveners, our Vice Chancellor, Dean, DOR, AD Sir, Gorantiwa Sir, their entire team, definitely for providing us a platform or opportunity to share our views with you people. That will definitely, I can, if possible, if you have liked it, definitely it will help you people. You can feel free to ask me, you can feel free to mail me. There are a number of scholarships still going on, Nehru Fulbright Fellowships. Their doors have opened just now in the month of, you can say, last week of January. You can apply for through that one. Number of fellowships are being there. You can apply. Definitely, I wish you all the best. And this is, you can say, just a start. Let's begin. Be a Spartan. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for accepting our invitation and delivering very wonderful lectures. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for sharing your...
One question is there, I think, from Durugeshwari Ratnakar. Sir, is it difficult to afford foreign studies? Not at all, my dear friend. I will share that two things. Thank you for asking this thing. Actually, if you calculate during when I went to US in 2014, the fellowship which I get was near about $43,006 per year. That counts near about $3,660 per month, which is the maximum fellowship that I got. But I can say that the major expenses over there were related with your lodging and boarding. as far as you can say things are concerned, you are going to prepare your own food. That will reduce your complete cost. The only thing is with the resident that you can share. Many Indian students, that is master students, they were getting $1,500 fellowship and $2,000 fellowship. For those particular people, $375 was the rent of the room. For me, the rent was $1,400. But when we went for the sharing, it came down to $700. And as far as the food is concerned, food is marvelous one. You can purchase anything, and max, whatever you can do, you can enjoy in your own way. I will not tell you on this particular platform, but you can enjoy in your own way. That will cost not more than $120. That's it, $120. If you are getting $1,000 fellowship, then it will be sufficient to meet your expenses too. That is my experience, my own experience. I used to send back. Actually, I already told you that I was not able to get my salary. So I used to send $2,000 from that place to India. That was more than you can say my salary. So that is not a play, you can say bar. Thank you for asking this question.
Okay, thank you very much, sir, for sharing your postdoctorate journey in USA, which is very helpful to our student, those who have preparing postdoctorate in abroad. Thank you very much, sir. There is one announcement. As per the interest of the our participants, we have organized lectures at 9 a.m. Expert is Dr. Vijay Paradkar, Senior Development Facilitator, Greenville, North Carolina, United States. He has delivering lecture on strategies for higher agriculture education in abroad, from tactical to practical. So all the participants take a note and join this lecture as per the time. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you, Dhumar sir.
Haan, bolo ke, madam.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.